Today we're talking about investing in yourself because there are a lot of scammers out there and there are a lot of myths about what it means to do that. What's up, guys? Brandon here from KDMR Music, the channel helping you become a more successful musician. Now, if you're new around here, we do videos every single week. I give you music business education, I give you marketing tips, and I give you strategies that you can use to grow your music career and be more successful, of course. Now, if you're new around here and you're interested in that type of content, hit the subscribe button, then hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our videos. Now, today we're talking about what it means to invest in yourself. I'm going to give you a list of things that it's actually good to invest in because there are a lot of scammers out there and there are a lot of myths about what it means to actually do that. Now, in the music industry and especially in the hip hop world where I come from, the words invest in yourself are almost like taboo. It's almost like cursing at somebody, like making them ready to want to fight you, right? Because there are so many people who offer these really scammy services like playlist promotion or paying for followers or paying for Instagram likes or YouTube views, or they pay to get on they pay to get on shows, or they charge you to perform at their shows. Like, there are so many different scams in the music business, and a lot of the people who run these scams will tell you a line, or they'll say something like, "Hey man, if you're not serious about your career, if you're not willing to invest in yourself, then no one's going to take you seriously." And it's true. If you don't invest in yourself, if you don't invest in your craft, then people are going to have a hard time taking you seriously, and you're going to have a hard time growing. But a lot of the people who are telling you to invest are telling you to invest in things that enrich them and not you. So I'm going to tell you about some things that you should be investing in and what it really means. Now, because there are so many bad actors in the music business, there is one myth that people believe, right? And the biggest myth that people believe is that an investment, or that any type of payment to someone or something, means it's a scam. Right. And so we think, hey, the only way to grow a successful music career is to not spend any money at all and to just spend a ton of effort, right? Reaching out to people, putting your links on people's posts on Facebook, spamming people, doing all sorts of nonsense, right? Instead of just hiring someone or offering people value in exchange for helping you to grow your audience. So just because somebody is asking you for money does not make them a scammer, but scammers are rampant in the music industry. So let's talk about what it means to really invest in yourself. Because the truth is that if you aren't willing to risk something, then you're not going to get much of a reward in the music business. So I'm going to talk about some investments, real investments, and how you can make the most of them. Now, the first thing that I think every artist should invest in is learning. It is education. And when I say invest, I don't mean pay some guru $1,000 to tell you how to succeed in the music business. Now, you could do that, and that may even fast track you and really give you a lot of knowledge in a small amount of time. But it's not necessary. You don't have to pay for one of these super expensive online courses. And Lord knows that everybody that takes those courses does not end up being a successful musician. So educating yourself can be something as simple as buying a book, right? I'm the author of the Music Marketing Guidebook, and maybe it's not good practice to actually plug my own book in this spot, so I won't. Instead, I'll recommend a couple of others. The one book that I recommend everyone purchase is How to Make It in the New Music Business by Ari Herstand. Now, Ari has been on my podcast. He's been on this YouTube channel. So I'll leave a link to our interview in the YouTube card and in the description of this video. But the book is amazing because it talks about how to succeed in the music business from the perspective of an artist that has done it. So How to Make It in the New Music Business is a great book. And another great book is All You Need to Know About the Music Business by Donald Passman, who, among other things, was Kanye West and Taylor Swift's lawyer. really, really good person to, or a really knowledgeable person who can tell you all about the industry from a more traditional standpoint. So those are two books that you can invest in. I actually have a video where I break down the top five music business books, and both of those are on it. So check that out in the description as well. Now, another thing that you can invest in is training, not just educating yourself on how the business works, but you can invest in training to become a better musician. There are software tools like Melodix or online learning platforms like Skillshare, where you can learn the actual skill of being a musician. You can learn the skill of songwriting. You can invest in a vocal coach to help you sing better, to help you breathe better. So investing is really just taking time and effort and money and resources and putting them into your craft, right? So again, invest in training, invest in resources that are going to help you be a better musician, invest in quality sound, invest in instruments, invest in better microphones, right? Invest in professionals that can help you achieve the things that you're looking for. So you can invest in education, you can invest in learning, you can invest in technical training, and then you can invest in your workforce, right? Hiring people to help you get to the next level. People like a manager, a publicist, a booking agent. Now, one thing about all three of those people, well, actually, just two of them, your manager and your booking agent, they're only going to work on commissions. So if someone's trying to charge you up front, they are a scammer. Now, a publicist actually works with you on a retainer basis. So it's a flat fee per month or even per campaign. But what they're not going to do is say, hey, I can get you on Complex if you pay me $50. It's not what a publicist does. They don't guarantee you coverage anywhere, but they will tell you, hey, I can reach out to my network, help you get more exposure. But those are the types of people that you want to invest in, people that can actually take your career to the next level. Now, I'm actually got another video about publicists that I'll leave in the description of this one as well. So you can invest in learning. You can invest in training, technical training. You can invest in the workforce or people that can actually help grow your career. And the last thing I would advise you to invest in would be systems. Systems that help make your job as a musician easier, right? Those can be project management systems or softwares like Asana or Meet Edgar. Asana is a project management tool, especially if you're working with a team, helps you keep track of tasks and how good or how far you are into completing them. Meet Edgar is a social media scheduling tool. There are others like Hootsuite and TweetDeck, things like that. But using a social media scheduling program is going to help you create content and help you get it published without spending all your time glued to your phone. So investing in systems, things that other people can use, as well as yourself, to help you grow in your career. Things that you can invest in so that when it's time to hire staff, you can explain to them how to use it, and now they can work for you, right? So just to recap, investing is not necessarily a scam. There are definitely scammers that you need to look out for. But just because you are investing or just because you're putting money into something doesn't mean you're automatically getting scammed. There are good things that you can invest in. You can invest in education. You can invest in technical training. You can invest in people or human resources, the workforce. And you could even invest in systems, software, programs that are going to help you get better, right? All of those are great investments to make into yourself as a musician. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. I highly encourage you to make these investments in yourself, right? You can invest money, of course, but you can also just invest time. Watching videos on this YouTube channel is an investment into your career, and it doesn't cost you anything except the 10 or 15 minutes that I take to explain a concept to you. So subscribe to the channel. If you don't want to miss out, hit the notification bell so that YouTube tells you every time I release a video. I'll see you in another video very soon, but until then, be safe, be well, keep dreaming, and work hard to make those music business dreams your reality. Peace.